So right now we're measuring, see how long the fry are. We have a chart that shows that at a given length, there's so many fry per pound. So we're trying to figure out what size they are right now so we get a good count when we start harvesting the basin to stock out into their grow out ponds. We want to put in roughly 80,000 per acre in our grow out ponds. So if we can get a good estimate on how many there is per pound, then we just know how many pounds we need to put into each pond. So those are averaging a half an inch, which our chart shows that there's 8,000 per pound, but we need 10 pounds to get 80,000. Y'all ready?
I'm ready.
Oh yeah, get that money shot right there. Hello.
Good spot.
Each time they get a bucket in here, we add to the list on the chart we've made. It keeps track of how many pounds we've got so far and total number. Right now we're at 61,600 fish, 7.7 pounds. We still need to get another 18,400 fry. We'll have to wait and bring the rest of the pond in and see if we can fill it with that. These will all go out into our grow ponds. There's 80,000 per acre. They'll stay in for approximately two and a half weeks, get up to an inch and a half, and then get harvested and taken to the lakes. So we have stocked fingerlings at Grand Lake in the past, but because they're farther north, cooler climate, we didn't see success of those fingerling stockings. So by stocking these adult fish, we know that they'll have a much better chance of survival. And then once these fish spawn in Grand Lake, we're gonna have the ability to produce F1 hybrids, which are more cold tolerant than the pure Florida bass, which is what these fish are. And the idea there is that their offspring have a better chance of survival, but also still maintain that great growth potential that we see from the Florida genetics. So this is kind of a in-lake F1 stocking program by putting these fish up at Grand.
Get on. Probably best one, that shows 90.
We just finished up fry harvest for the year. We'll wait 2 weeks, 3 weeks, and do fingerling harvest.
We're headed out to Grand Lake, stock some brooders. Hopefully they'll spawn with the northern bass and make a F1. So we'll see.
And so if you're a bass angler out there right now and you're targeting bass and going after, you know, bass on spawning beds and trying to catch a big one, just remember that if it's a trophy to you, that's all that matters. It's a trophy in your eyes.